oog is van koper, toch ligt er geen loon.
Na 109, geef een ongelooflijk applaus. Little John, Robbie John, Rodriguez! En dan zijn tegenstander een ervaren man. Hij heeft al flink wat gewonnen op de Pro Tour. Staat op de 14e plek op de wereldranglijst. Ook als 14e geplaatst voor deze Dutch Darts Masters. Please welcome the Demolition Man, Darren Webster!
And I ain't got nothing to say. I come home in the morning. I go to bed feeling the same way. I ain't nothing but tired. Man, I'm just tired and bored with myself. Hey there, baby. I could use just a little help. You can't start a fire. You can't start a fire without a spark. This gun's for hire.
An afternoon session that has seen wins for Brendan Dolan, Simon Whitlock, Jermaine Watamina, Rapid Ricky Evans, Dennis Nielsen of Sweden, Gerwin Price, the Grand Slam champion, and even improbably Paul Nicholson on stage. We'll end with Robbie John Rodriguez, the top performer from round one here at the Dutch Darts Masters, against Darren Webster. Now, the Demolition Man has been struggling pretty badly, actually, with an injury to his elbow of late. He's been struggling to even lift his arm up to throw the dart. He battled on gamely on the Pro Tour quite recently, but had to withdraw in his match because he just could not complete the game. But having spoken to him briefly earlier, he says that he is fit and raring to go. He even lifted up a chair to demonstrate his ability to wield that arm. But Robbie John Rodriguez, I tell you what, the way he wielded his darts yesterday was spectacular. The best we've ever seen from the young Austrian. Little John against even littler Darren.
To Roy first. Game on.
The winner makes it through to round three to face either the King, Mervyn, or Daryl Gurney, the Premier League semi-finalist. Rob Mullarkey is here to talk you through the final game of the afternoon session in Zvolle.
Yes, I was very impressed by Rodriguez yesterday, the fourth highest first round average ever on the European Tour. A record held by Michael Smith from his 6-0 walloping of Dave Palace in Austria 5 years ago. The first three dart average was 123.13. There was no let up at all from Rodriguez yesterday in beating Mike Dedeker, who went home despite that 94. Healthy sum plus average of his own. 6 180s in a match that had a total of 10.
140.
And Robbie John Rodriguez is a man who has beaten Darren Webster before. Not only that, the first time they met, it was 6-0 in favour
140.
Of RJ Rod. Webster has since won their most two recent encounters, although both 42. Were some time ago.
Yeah, Roby really needs to start doing bits, though, doesn't he, on the tour? Because at the minute, he is outside the top 100 in the world rankings.
Yeah, tied for 112 on the Order of Merit, 99th on the Pro Tour Order of Merit.
40.
And if he can use all that momentum generated from yesterday, it could well be a passage into the final day. 152 for the opener.
Ball or treble 18. Okay, easy, that'll seven. Leave him 65. And starting more brightly in this one.
100. Robbie requires 65.
Another 25 leave tops.
He's on the first leg.
That'll do for Roby John.
Second leg Darren, who throw first.
One of two Austrians we'll see today, this evening. That session will close with an Austrian player in action as well, as Mensur Suljovic takes to the stage. Mensur up against Vincent van der Voort tonight. That could be lively. I'd imagine the hall will fill up further for this evening session with Barney van Gerwen, Vincent, of course, as well as some stars from outside of the Netherlands like Peter Wright, Mensur himself, and the Diamond Ian White, who is on quite the run on the European Tour, three finals in a row, winning one of them.
And he's just arrived in the building as well.
16. Ah.
So he's here in good time. Of hours on the practice board for the number two seed.
140.
And again, Darren Webster leaves himself on 120. This time, it's taken him one fewer visit to reach that.
Yeah, started off that 180 though, but it has tailed off in the main since then.
63. Only 120.
Tops he wants then.
He's on
and
the
that's
second
a good sign for Darren Webster. Double top very much his double of choice, and if he's pinning it first dart, bit like Gowen Price, he can just cruise through games relying on it, taking it out first or second dart time after time after time. Very impressive display from Gerwen, averaging 103. Second time we've seen someone average more than 103 today, with the wizard Simon Whitlock, who really did need it against Florian Hempel, whom I really hope we see plenty more of this year.
Well, he'll 60. Be hoping that it's not another 17 attempts he needs to get to the next European Tour event.
I just don't see how it can be with the way he's
I
played.
Honestly, yeah, I know he went close against Clemens last year, and there was one other Euro Tour event last summer as well, where he again got to the final round of qualifying. But on the evidence of what we've seen this weekend, I'm staggered it has taken him so long. Although, like you said, those 17 attempts have all come sandwiched in the space of two and a bit years.
Well, the frustration is 60. That Florian Hempel is a German non-tour card holder. He'll have the opportunities in those German host nation qualifiers where there are four spots available. The other tournaments, he's only got two spots to go for, as Roby John puts in his first maximum. The next three European Tour events are in Copenhagen in Denmark, Prague in the Czech Republic, and just outside Vienna in Austria. So he's got a long while to wait before we're back in Germany.
This is true. And by then, who knows, he may have ditched the darts and become a javelin thrower.
He's on the third leg, Roby John Rodriguez.
15 darter for Roby John. This game going on throw at the moment.
100.
Webster again had that, well, a pretty disappointing doubleheader on the Pro Tour last weekend. He took home just 500 quid in prize money. Suffered
easy
a
one.
Ninth first round defeat in his 14 Pro Tour events this year. But as Dan said, the have been extenuating circumstances of late with this arm injury. Doesn't seem 60. To be suffering too much with it today. He was constantly rubbing that elbow during the course of his campaign in both Graz and in Munich as well, I remember.
177!
I think it was in Munich where it first came to light. I remember him speaking to Elmar about it on stage.
Well, he is a battler. I mean, it was 100. Against Devin Peterson, actually. Weirdly, he pulled out that game and he was 5-0 down, and they were in the sixth leg. And he was only averaging the 60s. He could barely throw. Devon was playing the best darts I think I've ever seen from him. He's averaging 110. It was mad.
82.
There were people who would have pulled out of that game just because Devon was so good, let alone you couldn't throw a dart. Beautiful. Double 16. And he's coming back because Webster cannot finish 159. This should be the first break of throw in this one.
49, Roby McGuire, 32.
Anxious times for Roby.
16. There and you require 110.
Well, those sorts of opportunities were in the main going yesterday.
Well, he decided to stay there. Darren Webster is a player who doesn't mind throwing his darts 16. Over the top of previous ones or just to the side as he was trying there, but didn't work out. This should work out. But it might not. Relief was the overwhelming driver behind that celebration, I think.
Yes, I think that's a fairly safe assumption. Roby John Rodriguez made hard work of that one, but it is the first break of throw in this match. He is off to a flyer here as well.
Well, we saw him piling in the big scores in the first round. The first couple of legs, we weren't seeing that from Roby John Rodriguez, but the last three legs, 60. Or two and a half, he's hit two 180s and a 177. And if he can just maintain in this groove, then he might be able to out-muscle Darren Webster.
40.
But look at that, what a way to follow it. 180, 40. And you can just see him telling himself, calm down.
136.
It has been a long while since we've seen Roby John Rodriguez go and win back-to-back games on the European Tour.
140.
Yeah, he is making his debut this year here. Only three appearances last year on the European Tour, although two of those were here in the Netherlands as well, so maybe there's something about this neck of the woods that he likes and enjoys.
65.
But his best performance in Europe remains his run to the quarters at the European Match Play in Innsbruck, so on home soil in 2015.
We require 76.
Yeah, well, it's the German Darts Masters from 2017 in April, so more than 2 years since he made the last 16 in one of these events.
56.
And had that dart found double top, 4-1, he may have been bound there for the first time in more than 2 years, and he's going to come back.
54. We require 20.
Yeah, anger for Darren Webster as he snatched his darts back out of the board. Double five. And there's real daylight between the two of them now. It is just the one break of throw, but
100.
4-1 looks a lot, doesn't it, in a first to six race.
There is no guarantee that a player, as a teenager who looks like he's one of the brightest prospects in any sport, in any field, there is no guarantee that they're going to go on and realise that potential. And there is no real guide as to when they might do it. But Roby John Rodriguez was one of the hottest properties in youth darts for a good long while. And it has not happened for him over the last few years. He's 25 years old now.
140.
And if he is going to be a major force in the world of darts, the next couple of years, you think, would be really, really important. We've seen him do 100. Something he's never done before, go and average almost 110 on a big stage. That's happened this weekend in Zwolle. And you never know. It could be a couple of years from now when you look back and think, yeah,
90.
That's when he started to become the player that we now know, one of the top boys.
100. Over you, 164.
Another. Oh, my word.
Was there a slight deflection on the way through there? Either way.
It's a great lie for it, didn't it? But that's superb because he's forcing Darren Webster to take out an enormous check out of his own. Yeah.
And you feel the way that Rodriguez has suddenly found his shooting boots. This has to go for Darren Webster, and it may well go for Darren Webster. Double 18. Oh, brilliant. What a salvation job that is from the demolition man. That's
brilliant. He is not going quietly, Darren Webster. And rare for Webster, who's usually so eager to get on with the game and throw, took his time and pinned it. Another big visit from Roby John.
140.
Yeah, just wanted to get back up there ASAP, didn't he? But look at this from Roby John in response. Brilliant stuff.
He left himself in a position to hit the perfect leg yesterday. He could not go any further than six darts. And he does not go any further than six darts here. But if he gets the leg one, it's 5-2. And Darren Webster is, look, after taking out a 1-5-6 checkout, that is a real gut punch. And then he's just shrugged it off and thrown six perfect darts.
I'm trying to think, did he end up winning the leg where he threatened the nine darts?
100, Rabiquan 58.
He's very nearly squandered it, certainly, and he'd be just desperate to get this fifth leg on the board. And he comes through with an 11 darter, and Darren Webster just put back in his place. There might just have been a bit of fire in the belly of Darren Webster after that 1-5-6, but Rodriguez has just nullified that really effectively.
And his average has climbed to more than 97 right now, and that's with 10 missed darts at double. Roby John Rodriguez is playing as well as I have seen him play in a long, long time this week. Arguably better. I've seen him play this sort of stuff before, but yesterday was something absolutely brand new. And to follow it up with a performance like this is a phenomenal sign for the young Austrian. Mensur Suljovic has kind of been flying the flag on his own of late, because Zoran Lurchbacher has not been playing brilliantly. Roby hasn't done a great deal.
And in terms of the World Cup selection, there's not a lot between them, is there, either? Obviously, Mensur's head and shoulders above the rest, but
93
on this form, he'd like to take Rodriguez to the World Cup.
93.
Well, Webster does his bit, leaves himself double 12.
Yeah, Rodriguez, I think, may just be forgetting about 24. This leg. It's all about the next one for him. Although there may be an opportunity to take out this 1-3-6, and there will be.
136.
Well, this would be one heck of a way to steal it and to seal it.
Just yanked that one down. I'll tell you what I have. I mean, look, it's very easy to play the game with the right attitude when you're playing really well. And he is playing really well, Roby John Rodriguez. But we've not seen any of the sort of petulance or lazy darts or throwing legs away. And he's got himself an opportunity here. And this could be a 6-2 win. And Roby John Rodriguez, who has not made the final day of a Euro Tour for more than 2 years, wants double six.
Oh, it was all
72. Only requires six.
Well, the way that Darren Webster's been making hard work of this, he may well get a chance. And he will get another chance.
Rabi require six.
And this two-year wait for a place in the final day of a European Tour event may just be about to come to an end for Roby John Rodriguez. My word, he's covered a lot of that bed. Over to the left-hand side. And he finds a way through. And Roby John Rodriguez backs up that stylish win yesterday against Mike Dedeker with, well, a very effective and just as equally eye-catching win over the number 14 seed, Darren Webster. The number 14 seed makes another early exit on the European Tour. But for RJ Rod, he is through to the final day once again. And just look what it means. A great way to round things off in the afternoon session here in Zvolle. Do join us for the evening session from 7:15. All the big guns on stage, starting with Dave Chisnell and Steve Beaton. The world number one, Michael van Gerwen, begins his defence of the title once again here, the five-time champion in Zvolle, with Daryl Gurney, Michael Smith, Peter Rice and Mensur Suljovic also on the card tonight.
Congratulations, Rob. It's the very, very first time you make the Sunday on the Dutch Darts Masters.
Is it? I've done the Sunday on the BDO tournament on Sunday.
But no, you're playing either Daryl Gurney or Mervyn King tomorrow. Now you've beaten Mike Dedeker, you've beaten Darren Webster. Seems like the opponents are getting tougher and tougher every time.
Yeah. To be honest, Darren wasn't on his form today. I'm happy to win that game. I played awesome yesterday. I didn't recognize yesterday that you told me that. But I'm still hoping and keep fighting. Every trip I'm going, I'm making worth it.
Well, you're going to be back tomorrow, so we're looking forward to seeing you. Dames en heren, morgen is hij terug. Geef hem nog een keer een hartelijk applaus. Roby John Rodriguez! And